MajorCommand.com, seriously kick-ass strategy gaming. What's up people, Bedorty's here. Gonna run down the features of the interface. There's a lot to cover, so I'll try and get through it pretty briskly. This is called the action button. You begin your turn, you end your turn. You get through the different phases by clicking that. The person's turn it is will be underlined. This is a list of players in the order that they will play. So Bedorty's goes, and then Robin Ali has been eliminated. That's why they have a slash to their name. So after me will go Granz, and then Tudor, and then Patrick, etc. If I mouse over a player's name, it will highlight the regions they own, which is good to get a quick sense of where they are on the map. So these round buttons you might not use too much, but if you wanted to go back and see what the game state looked in previous rounds, you would do that. Clicking the names button here will turn the names of all the regions on or off. You can keep them off if you know you don't need them, but sometimes you want to refer to a region and you're not sure what it is, so you would click that names button there. The size will obviously change the size of your map. Some people like it smaller, some people like it bigger. There's three sizes. This is the biggest size right here. Help button will display some help text if you need it. The colors is kind of cool. You can change your color. Let's say I want to be orange. You can also change everyone else's color. Like I'm going to change this person to pastel or something like that. So just keep in mind that everyone has their own set of colors. So I can't refer to Granz as purple, because he might not be purple himself, or Tudor might have him as red or something like that. So this is just kind of helpful. I always set myself to black. It's just so I know who I am. That's just my preference. And another trick is that sometimes I'll set neutrals to clear, or if there's a guy that I want to specifically target and I want to make sure that I get all of him, you know, I'll set him to red, so I'll make sure that I can see all of them really quickly. So that's the top screen. Oh, this is the timer. It says 18 hours left. This is obviously a casual game. So back down here are several tabs which are also going to be used pretty frequently. Intel, you kind of always want to be checking this to see who's in the lead in terms of troops, how many reserves, etc. These are people's ranks, which is something good to watch out for. Robin Ali is a cadet, so you know, eliminated first. But you know, high-ranking people you want to watch out for, as well as Patrick, who is on kitchen patrol. You don't want to be eliminated by him either. So you want to keep track of, you know, how many troops are due. I see MTR has 7 on his next turn. You know, that's pretty big. The chatter is where people can chat. You know, just say hello, good luck, or anything like that. It will show it by round, so you know how recent this was. Diplomacy is a feature which you should probably read a little bit more in depth on, but you can basically make an agreement between two borders not to attack each other. So let's say with Robin Ali, or let's see where I am up here. Okay, I'm blue, so I'm in the stands, and maybe I'll make an agreement with China, who is Tudor. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Tudor, I'm going to click the stands in China, and I'm going to say make an agreement for, 3 rounds. And that doesn't mean we can't attack each other, but if we do, you know, that's not good form. It's going to lower our diplomacy rating, etc. So generally you try and keep diplomacy requests. He has to agree to this in order to go into effect. So there's a lot more nuanced things about diplomacy, but that's the short of it right there. The record will show all of the actions taken by all of the players. So, you know, that's something to check back every now and then. The brief will show more information about the map, the bonuses, and all the rules variants going on right here. You definitely want to keep that in mind just to make sure you know what the reinforcement allowance is, etc. The personnel tab is where you can mark players as honorable or dishonorable. You know, if someone you know, screws me over or is rude in the chat, I might mark them dishonorable. Or, you know, some of these players I played a lot with, so, you know, they're pretty honorable. I like them, and I'll mark them as such. So those are the basic features, and a lot to take in. So good luck out there. MajCom.